Hi YouTube, it's Thomas again, and my little wizard Thomas TitanSlinger. We're just going to do, this is probably going to turn out to be a long video, or I'm going to stop it in the middle and split it halfway, but it's a bit of a biggish topic. It's using the rug glitches that you've been shown in a previous video to build platforms up into the sky, how to start creating paths, you know, building paths and stuff like that up in the sky. And we do that by building up with scaffolding. So we'll drop straight into it. It's a fair bit to cover, and I don't want the video to sort of crank on too long. So I'm going to start. I'll throw down a small blue trim rug and a tatami mat. I've said before, it's what I always use to do all of my little trickeries and glitcheries. Now I'm going to pop down a scaffolding here and put a small blue trim rug on top like that. Now back over. Yeah, no, I'm going to pull the scaffolding over to here, I reckon. What you'll find, the reason this is going to go on for a bit is we're going to look at how you drop stuff down over the edge of something, and how I might build down to that water, for example, to put a path in there like I've done in one of my houses. And you'll see as we come up to the edge here and turn around, there's actually like a wall here, and you can't easily build out over it. We actually have to go up to go over, so we get to cover both topics in one. Woo! Here we go. I'm just going to drop down a flat wooden platform. Now these I buy in the crown shop, and whilst it's crown shop, they're not a crown shop, like a crown's item. You'll get those for gold. If you go flat wooden platform, click on the gold tab, and there we go. Other items that you can buy for gold pop up in the housing in the crown shop, if you didn't know that already. So you don't need to have crowns to buy them. You can use gold to buy them, and I find that they're one of the best building items. Anyway, here we go. I'm going to select the blue small blue trim rug and just pop it so the tatami mat's underneath, as you've seen with floating objects and glitching objects. And we're going to move the tatami mat now and place this platform up onto the first shelf of the scaffolding there. Now that's basically it. That's how we're going to start shooting up and build up very, very quickly. I'm going to remove these items here. You'll see if I go to select the scaffolding and move that, everything's going to go with it. We don't want that, so I'll right mouse click and drop it back into its position. I'm going to select the small blue trim rug, and if I move it first and just make sure it's not going to take everything, perfect. So I'll pick it up, and the same with this little mat. I'm going to move it. I'm actually going to just flip it around over here to save some time and chuck down my next platform. There we go. Now if I spin around here, I'm just going to put a scaffolding up on top here again. I'm going to build off to my left and out here, because if you start to put platforms over the top of where you've got things on the ground, when we go to twist them or move them or pick them up, sometimes the items that you've placed underneath them can go as well. So it's good to be mindful of what you're building over or out over the top of, or even underneath if you've got stuff up in the sky, because often if I had a pathway floating over the top of these mats and I pick them up and move them, I'll pick up the pathway that's up in the sky. It's really frustrating, and I speak from experience. Let me just slide this platform back a little bit. There we go. Some room to get my mats in here. There we go. Stick that up on the platform here. Oh, I don't have a blue trim rug up on top of the platform. Perfect. Select my blue trim rug, move it, it's not attached, perfect, we're doing well. There we go, you can see along here, I'm still not high enough to go over the edge or lip or wall that they put along the cliff here, so we're going to go up one more. I'll just pop a scaffolding on the end here, like that. Look at a little blue trim rug on top, and a platform in there. That might not be enough. No. You'd think I'd learn, but anyway. Okay. Now, this time, what I might actually do silly. I'm going to move this scaffold to this side. There we go. And chuck my mat up. And hopefully... Ah, it's not going to let me. Okay. That's silly. Let me pick that up. Move that rug back down there. I'm just going to move that back down there. Okay, so I'm going to chuck a scaffolding back on this side. What happened there was the invisible wall that stood there wouldn't let me run up onto the platform that I'd placed, which was pretty dumb of me, really. I'm going to pop this there while I'm standing there and then move backwards, and there I go, jumping up onto it. Okay, so you can see what I'm doing, just repeating the process over and over of scaffolding, blue trim rug on the scaffolding, move that. It's not attached, I can pick it up, and then I'm going to pop this over there. So that's essentially it. We've just sort of built up quite some good distance, or only three so far. I've taken it up to about 30 platforms up in the sky. What you can start doing is removing platforms as you build up. I put teleporter points up on the platforms. Oh, a bit of a blackout. There we go. I put teleporter points up here. And then when you when we start working my way out here somewhere, if I need platforms, if I've run out, I start picking up the platforms, take them with me, and just put teleporter points and go to and from down where I'm working. What we're going to do here, a couple of things. I'm going to pick up the teleporter, drop down a platform here, and we'll pretend that we're some considerable height up in the sky. It's then how do you start manipulating the platforms around and building onto them and so forth. I'm going to pick that up for the moment. And here, I'm going to pop down a little tatami rug and stick it onto the platform there. Doesn't matter, that's okay. And I'm going to pick up that tatami mat. Now I stick it over the top of this platform, and you'll see that it actually drops into position there. Lovely. Look at that. So we can start to build a great big area up here of platforms together. You can actually move them out of the way and get rid of that tatami mat, and this is a pretty simple little trick, and this is a good one to learn and to play with your platform, because it's how I build up onto get stepping stone runways in the sky and stuff like that. We place a rug. I'm not going to put it down. You'll hear I haven't clicked and moved it. I'm just letting it sit there, and I rotate the mouse scroll. And much like getting the rugs out the way when a rug's stuck under a housing item, I just move that out the way there. I can move this one out the way here and pick it up. Now, if I teleport out of the house, or I run down from here and go inside the house and come back here again, it resets it, and they'll both go back to the original position that I put them in. I'm just going to flip that around like that. And that one there, I can't remember where I had the rug, but it's kind of about like that. That'll do. Now, I reckon I'm going to pause it there and say thanks very much for watching. That's the end of this building platforms up into the sky, because it will just run into the video goes too long otherwise. But I'll kick straight into another video now on how to sink the objects back over the edge and get them going down to the water level down there below us. So thanks very much for watching. If you like, please subscribe, and I'll catch you again for another video very shortly. Bye.